Hi, welcome back. On the last video, we learned how to pull some information from the database and how to refactor some of the code that we had into a function, right? Like this, and we made a new database file and functions and all that, all right? If you haven't watched the last video, make sure you do. But anyway, on this one here, we're going to continue, and we are going to be making the query so that way we go to the database and update this field and this field relating to whatever ID we have on the database. So for example, if I click on ID number one and I put a username here and a password, that will update ID number one here, which in this case would be my name. All right, so let's go ahead and jump into that code and let's start doing this. I'm gonna take a couple things. As a matter of fact, let's just make it right here real quick. I think we can make it faster than we can copy it. Let's just do an if set. Make sure that first, let's just put this here, the famous PHP tag. I always think I have it because, right? All right, so we're going to do an iSet function here, and just to check for the post super global. All right, I'm going to try to do this a little faster since this would be a little longer than usual, but hopefully it's not longer than 5 or 6 minutes, all right? So keep tuned for this. You're going to like it. All right. So as a matter of fact, I'm just going to do it from scratch. Why not? I should not do this. I should be copying code that we already have from the last videos, but I just like making mistakes. That way I can fix them up. All right. If you like to be 100% sure of things, especially when you are starting, just make sure that you copy the stuff from the other files, because we already have this from the other file. I just like writing this stuff down because I like making mistakes. It makes me a better programmer. All right, for some reason I'm just strange. Don't worry, don't mind me. Okay, so anyway, we're going to be picking these fields from the form, right? So every time we submit the form, we are going to be pulling this information from there. All right, and we're going to be putting it in the post associated array, and we're gonna do the ID also. All right, we're gonna be pulling that out. You see that we are sending the ID right here with the name attribute, we're sending the password, we're sending the username. All right, so if all this is set, then what do I want to do? This information, I think, as a matter of fact, let's just create it. I was gonna copy it, but that's fine. Let's just create this a query here real quick, and the query is gonna be update. And this is just SQL, okay? So we're gonna update the users table that we've been working on, and we're gonna set a value, a couple values, and we're gonna set the username. And this keyword here, I'm picking it up. This is the name of the column in the database. So if I edit this, you see this column name? That's what I'm using there, and I'm gonna be using the password column name also. All right, so just for you to know that this is in the users table. If you click on the users, you can see the table. This is the rows, but you can edit that and you can look at that if you want to just look at it real quick. All right. As a matter of fact, I'm going to break this down. This line would be too long, so I'm just going to break that down and I'm going to concatenate it into another query variable. And this would be the same variable, basically. I'm just concatenating it. This is what this dot means. It would be the same as this, but in reality, PHP will actually think it's a really long string if I do it with the dot right here. I just don't want to do this dot, and it's a lot better because when I make mistakes, I can just go to each line and check to see if each line is good instead of checking this long string here, okay? So I'm just going to close that, and the username column is here now. Then with what do I want to update this column? With the username that's coming from the form, right? So I'm just going to copy this here and make sure that you have single quotes there, because this is going to be a string from the form, right? I'm going to copy this whole thing here, I'm going to paste it, I'm going to put the name of the other column in the database, password, and I'm just going to copy this and paste it right here. All right. Now, when I have the data right in front of me, I don't mind pasting. All right. So don't get me wrong. So now the next thing right here is that I'm going to use another command, SQL command called where. And that's just going to give me like a selection where I can select where what I want to do with this data to where I'm getting it from, right? So we're going to say something like where right here, where ID equals the ID that is coming from the form. Make sure that you don't put any quotes around the ID because it's not a string, it's an integer. Remember that. That data from the database is an integer. All right, so that's about it here. Now what I want to do is actually I want to check for result if I have a problem, because I don't know if I have a problem here. So we haven't made the query yet, so we need to make the query first. So let's go ahead and make the query. So I'm going to call this query the result. Again, we have these files already. What you can do is copy it if you want, or you can just write it down with me. All right, mysql I, and this is called query. And then here we're gonna pass the two parameters, the connection and the query. Again, this way, the way I'm doing it is prone to, for any programmer to make mistakes, because I'm writing everything down from scratch, and you can just copy it here. All right. This stuff is already here. You got the query and you got the result. You might be asking yourself, why is he writing it down? Well, one of the things is that I enjoy it. I enjoy making mistakes because the fun of actually finding out what's wrong with something is something that I like. And I think this way, if you follow me, you can learn a lot more just by typing things down. If I start copying and pasting, you're gonna be doing the same thing and you're gonna learn less. So if you don't appreciate that, then I don't know what you will appreciate. All right. So anyway, if I say if here and I say if not result, because I'm going to find out if this is not going to go through. So remember, this is going to give me true or false. So if the result doesn't come back as true from the query, meaning if the query did not go through, then I'm going to get an error, right? So I'm going to say die. This is the command that is going to stop all executions after this, and it's going to give the user a message. In this case, the user is me. And I'm just going to say query failed, man. It just failed. And of course, we need the quotes there. All right. So, are you ready to see the mistakes we made? All right. Let's go ahead and check it out. Pretty sure I did it super fast, and I'm pretty sure there's some mistakes somewhere. So, logging update. Perfect. Line 8. So we have unexpected password there. In line 8 in the login page. All right, line 8. Let's see, we probably forgot a semicolon or something. There we go, we forgot several of them. We did a copy and paste so fast, we didn't even put semicolons. Boom! Oh, it wasn't that nice. Look at that. Perfect. So it looks like it's working. I'm concerned. I don't like this. But anyway, let's go ahead and create another record in the database and let's find out if this is working. All right. So let's create this here. Let's just create another one. Say something like, wow. No. The code man. I like that name, code man. And I'm just gonna type in H, and submit. All right, we're gonna take this connected out of there. I just don't like it. I'm just gonna, but right now we're not gonna do that, of course. Let's just refresh here. And the code man, perfect. Let's go to our update file. I'm just gonna go from up here, update, right here. What's going on, Edwin? There we go. Let's click here and now we got a record. So let's select that same one, the code man, and let's name it the code woman. Right? Because men are not the only one coding, all right? I'm just letting you know. All right. So let's put some crazy password and update. Oh, yes, we have a mistake. Use undefined constant result. That means we forgot the S, the dollar symbol somewhere. Line 17. It could mean that, it could mean something else, right? Actually, that's this is not the file. Let's go to the file somewhere here. Boom. Line 17. Ha. Look at that. You see that? How beautiful that is? When you start reading this errors there. Query failed. Another error. Perfect. So, query fail. What can we do when the query fails like this? All right. Well, I'm going to show you a way that you can actually get some more information. Right? This is not enough information. MySQL error. Let's use MySQL I error. Because this is a new API. You should know that. And let's just put a connection here. I think that's the parameter it takes. What do you think? All right. Let's go ahead and check it out. Oh, you see that? This is nice now. Now we got a lot more information with this function right here. All right. So make sure you put this in your toolbox. MySQLi underscore error is going to give you a lot more information than this just little query fail function there. All right. All right. So you have an error in your SQL syntax. Check the manual that corresponds. The code woman where ID equals 7. Oh, I got a feeling it's somewhere here in line 1, right? So let's see if we can find this fast. All right, so let's check this. The way we can check this easy is actually by putting a comma here. I just figured it out. But anyway, I think that's the problem. So we need to put a comma in between these values, and it wasn't there. So make sure. I hope these mistakes will help you fix yours just in case and shine some light. You know, we as programmers spend more time fixing things than actually making them. So keep that in mind. Let's just click there. Perfect. The code woman. And let's just put some crazy code here. And 7. Update. Oh, perfect. We have a problem. Something is going on. It's not that comma there. So let's go and check it out. All right, perfect. So we have this comma here. It's not that. It says line 1. But remember, this whole thing is concatenating on one line. So, but it still helps me figure out what's going on. So update users, that's fine. Let's just put a space there. And let's check it out. The cold woman. 7 update. That was the problem. You saw that? Something as simple as not putting a space here. The problem is, if you don't put a space here, when you remember this is only one line, so users, I'm going to just copy it here. User is going to be like this to the set. So it's going to say set user. It's not going to say it in one word like this. Make sure you put a space there, right? And I always try to put spaces all around there just in case. So make sure you put spaces there. That was a problem. All right? So hopefully these little things will help you out and don't make you think, okay, the code woman, yes, let's update that file again. Let's do that. Let's create something like this. The code boy. And let's just say, all right, you don't know what I said, but you're going to see it now. Update. Perfect. And refresh. Haha, the code boy. Look what it says here. Hey, student, yes, it's working. We finally made this work, all right? Now, this video got kind of long. On the next lecture, I'm going to show you how to delete all this data from here, right? So hopefully you learn a lot on this one. Thank you, and I'll see you in the next lecture.